Hello everyone, I Abhishek Gagar and Priya Mann are going to highlight our view on the topic electromagnetic probe to shield a spacecraft for human space flight into deeper space mission. So here in the further slides, we will be explaining the following contents: introduction, what is radiations and types of radiations, shielding technologies, active shieldings, electrostatic shielding, plasma shielding, confined magnetic shield, unconfined magnetic shields, and mini magnetospheric plasma propulsions. So let's start with the introduction. First of all, we will talk about what is radiation. Radiation is a form of energy that is emitted in the form of rays, electromagnetic waves, or particles. Some radiations can be seen like visible light or felt like infrared radiations, while some are only observed with special equipment like X-rays and gamma rays. So what is space radiation? Space radiation is different from the kind of radiation we experience here on Earth. It is comprised of atoms in which electrons have been stripped away as the atom accelerated in space to speeds approaching the speed of light. Eventually, only the nucleus of atoms remains. It is made up of three kinds of radiations: particle trapped in Earth's magnetic field, particle shot into space during solar flares, or galactic cosmic rays. Now let's see galactic cosmic radiations. Galactic GCR is a dominant source of radiations that must be dealt with aboard current spacecraft and future space missions. GCRs comes from outside the solar system, but primarily within our Milky Way galaxy. GCR is composed to the nuclei of atoms that have had their surroundings electrons stripped away and are traveling at nearly the speed of light. To think of GCR would be to imagine the nucleus of any elements in the periodic table from hydrogen to uranium. Now imagine that same nucleus moving at incredibly high speed. The high speed nucleus you are imagining is GCR. Simply, GCR are heavy, high energy ions of elements that have had all their electrons stripped away. They can cause atoms they pass through to ionize. They can pass practically unimpeded through a typical spacecraft or the skin of astronaut. Now let's talk about SPE or solar particle events. SPE occurs when protons emitted by the sun become accelerated either close to the sun during a flare or in interplanetary space by CME, coronal mass ejection shocks. The event can include other nuclei such as helium ions and highly charged and energetic ions. Now let's talk about particle radiations. Particle radiation is the radiation of energy by means of fast-moving subatomic particles. Subatomic particles come from the nuclei of radioactive atoms. Now we will see what is shielding technologies. So shielding technologies, here are material shielding. First of all, we'll talk about material shielding. It consists of highly hydrogen materials like polythene, boron, BNNTs, hydrogenated boron, nitride, and nanotubes. It concretes and lead shield, which is 0.25 millimeter thick for secondary radiation and 0.5 millimeter thick for primary radiation. Next is artificial magnetosphere. Generated largely from deep within the planet, the magnetic field can be thought of as a huge bubble, protecting us from cosmic radiation and charged particles that bombarded Earth in solar winds. SRS2 project ESA Plus Sun use a superconducting wire made up of magnesium diboride coiled up by running electricity through the coil. It should be capable of producing a magnetic field 3,000 times stronger than the Earth. Now next is force field. To create, we require force which is repulsive and should be thin. Marco Peroni solution. Upper surface will be blocked for viewed, but sides will be similar to windows and one can view the space. It's very safe, very innovative, and realistic. Now come to graded zest shielding. Graded zest shielding is a laminate of several materials with different Z values. Z here represents atomic number. same mass of graded Z shielding has been shown to reduce electron penetration over 60%. It is used in satellite-based particle detection. Active shielding. Active shielding using magnets, high voltages, or artificial magnetospheres to slow down or deflect radiation has been considered to potentially combat radiation in a feasible way. Cost of equipment, power, and weight of active shielding equipment outweigh their benefits. Radiation shielding can be done in either in two ways, efficient material shielding or more material shielding. So let's talk about what is active shielding in brief. Active shielding are of four types. Electrostatic shields, which use an electric field strong enough to repel the cosmic rays. It must be of the order of 10 per 10 volts. Plasma shields, it requires magnetic field, it expands magnetic field, produces electric field, confined plasma to create an electrode. It is extremely high electrical potential required that traps electron at separation from spacecraft. Confined magnetic shields, it is used to deflect cosmic rays from crew quarters of the vehicle. Confined in double walled torus, it is attached coils. Unconfined magnetic shields, it is similar to confined magnetic shields, deflect cosmic rays, but field is allowed to expand. It is large coil of high superconductor deployed beyond the vehicle. It is deployed large diameter coil or shields bearing magnets. For further continuation, I would like to call my colleague Priya. Thank you.
Thank you, Abhishek, for briefing us about the active shielding technologies. The first technology that we are going to discuss is the electrostatic shield, which is based on a very simple idea of using strong electric field, which will be static and strong enough to repel the cosmic rays. The only condition is that it should be of it should be an order of 10 to the power 10 volts. And there are two forms of pure electrostatic shielding, and neither is sound. In one scheme, the space vehicle is pictured as being constructed of two concentric shells, and these shells act as a charged capacitor. In this arrangement, the space vehicle as a whole is electrically neutral. To be effective against galactic cosmic rays, the potential between the shells would have to be about 10 to the power 10 volt. However, this technology is not feasible currently, as the largest steady voltages produced on Earth between conductors that are found in the Van der Graaf machines cannot attain voltages higher than 20 megavolts. The next technology is the plasma radiation shield. Well, it will use an active device using free electrons and electric and magnetic fields for the purpose of shielding astronauts from energetic solar flare produced. No. Space purpose of fields are the electric field has the sole purpose of supporting the electric field by trapping electrons at a separation from the spacecraft. It follows the electric field that is required for the plasma radiation shield, and that is required for the pure electrostatic shield as well. Here we use the voltage on the order of 30 to 100 megavolts. Moving on to our next concept, it is a magnetic concept but in a confined field. Well, a strong magnetic field produced will deflect the cosmic rays from a distance in order to protect the crew. And to ensure the maximum protection, the confinement will be made of double walled and a torus shaped to deflect the radiation. And to confine the electron cloud around the vehicle with a magnetic field, the field lines must surround the vehicle without ever leading to it. This configuration can be realized if the vehicle is in the shape of a torus, or you can imagine torus as a donut, and an electric current is made to circulate around the torus. The magnetic field lines will then surround the torus, forming a dipole field configuration. This field contains the electron cloud. The force exerted on the electron of charge moving with the velocity v in magnetic field is perpendicular to both magnetic and the velocity. Well, this force binds each electron to field line. The electrons gyrate around the fields, spiraling along the lines as they circulate around the vehicle. However, a lot of mass will be required, which is equivalent to the mass of material shielding. Hence, it is again a failure concept because we require very minimum mass to be carried along with us in a spacecraft. Well, the electron cloud also needs to be permanently in motion to remain confined by the field, which is similar to a confined magnetic shield. In an unconfined magnetic shield, the concept is exactly similar. However, the only fact is that the field is not confined and its size can be extremely large. Then one problem may arise, and the problem is of cooling down the semiconductor wires used. Well, this design will take both material and intellect resources to set up successfully. Using a large superconductor coil imposes a challenge of heavy mass being carried on a spacecraft structure, which is similar to the problem of the confined magnetic shield. Last, we are going to discuss about mini magnetospheric plasma propulsion. When the plasma reaches sufficient pressure to overcome the magnetic field tension, the magnetic field expands to scale sizes very much larger than the original object. The laboratory prototype of the N2P2 used as plasma source embedded asymmetrical in a dipole-like magnetic field. The breakdown of the plasma can be produced at a neutral pressures of between about 0.25 to 1 megatorr. And the plasma densities are of order 10 to the power 11 to 10 to the power 12 centimeter cube. And with a temperature of few electric volts, well, the plasma pressure is sufficient to overcome a magnetic field of several hundred to thousand watts and cause the field's outward expansion or inflation into the mini magnetosphere. The motion of both open and closed field lines within the vacuum chamber is demonstrated through the optical emissions from the Helligan plasma. In the end, here I would like to present to you various important resources on the internet that have helped us through our research, and also I would like to acknowledge the efforts of our mentor Sudhir sir and the event organizers to provide us with the opportunity to deliver our research. Thank you all.